Today's topic, limits at infinity with radicals. Let us evaluate the limit of the quantity square root of 4x squared minus 3x plus 2x as x approaches negative infinity. If we are going to find the limit of the square root of 4x squared minus 3x as x approaches negative infinity, and then add the limit of 2x as x approaches negative infinity, what we will get is infinity plus negative infinity. Infinity plus negative infinity is indeterminate. The technique here is to divide the square root of 4x squared minus 3x plus 2x by 1. Then multiply the numerator and the denominator by the conjugate of the numerator. Let us do that. This is now equal to the square root of 4x squared minus 3x plus 2x over 1. To find the conjugate of the square root of 4x squared minus 3x plus 2x, just change this positive sign to negative. So the conjugate of the square root of 4x squared minus 3x plus 2x is the square root of 4x squared minus 3x minus 2x. So multiply the numerator by square root of 4x squared minus 3x minus 2x, and then the denominator 1 also by square root of 4x squared minus 3x minus 2x. To find the product of the square root of 4x squared minus 3x plus 2x and the square root of 4x squared minus 3x minus 2x, use the pattern a plus b times a minus b is equal to a squared minus b squared. The product of the sum and the difference of two terms is equal to a squared minus b squared. So this is now equal to, open parenthesis, the square root of 4x squared minus 3x close parenthesis squared minus open parenthesis 2x close parenthesis squared divided by the square root of 4x squared minus 3x minus 2x. Suppose we have the square root of 5 squared. This is equal to the square root of 5 times the square root of 5. And the square root of 5 times the square root of 5 is equal to the square root of 25. And the square root of 25 is equal to 5. Notice that when the index here is 2, or understood to be 2, and the exponent outside the parenthesis is 2, then the answer is the radicand. So this is now equal to 4x squared minus 3x, because the index here is understood to be 2 and the exponent outside the parenthesis is 2. And then minus 4x squared, because 2x times 2x is 4x squared, divided by the square root of 4x squared minus 3x minus 2x. Cancel 4x squared and negative 4x squared. And then divide the numerator and the denominator by the highest power of x appearing in the denominator, which in this case, it is x squared. But x squared is under the sign of square root. So divide the numerator and the denominator by square root of x squared. This is now equal to negative 3x over the square root of x squared divided by the square root of 4x squared minus 3x minus 2x. Then divide the square root of 4x squared minus 3x by the square root of x squared and 2x also by the square root of x squared. In algebra, we learned that the square root of x squared is equal to the absolute value of x, and the absolute value of x is equal to x if x is greater than or equal to 0, and it is equal to negative x if x is less than 0. So we can replace the square root of x squared by the absolute value of x. So this is now equal to negative 3x over the absolute value of x. For this part of the denominator, we can apply this property of radicals. The nth root of a divided by the nth root of b is equal to the nth root of a over b. So this is now equal to the square root of 4x squared over x squared minus 3x over x squared minus 2x over, replace this by the absolute value of x. We are solving for the limit of the function as x approaches negative infinity. So x is approaching negative infinity, hence x is less than 0. Therefore, the absolute value of x is negative x because x is less than 0. So we can replace this absolute value of x by negative x, and this absolute value of x also by negative x. This is now equal to negative 3x over negative x divided by the square root of 4x squared over x squared minus 3x over x squared minus 2x over negative x. Negative 3x divided by negative x is 3, and 4x squared divided by x squared is 4. 3x over x squared is 3 over x. 2x over negative x is negative 2, but this is negative. Negative, negative is positive, so plus 2. So this is now equal to 3 over the square root of 4 minus 3 over x plus 2. We can now find the limits of the numerator and the denominator. This is now equal to the limit of 3 as x approaches negative infinity divided by the square root of the limit of 4 as x approaches negative infinity minus the limit of 3 over x as x approaches negative infinity plus the limit of 2 as x approaches negative infinity. This is now equal to 3. 3 because the limit of 3 as x approaches negative infinity is 3 divided by the square root of 4 minus 0. 4 because the limit of 4 as x approaches negative infinity is 4. 0 because the limit of 3 over x as x approaches negative infinity is 0. And then plus 2. 2 because the limit of 2 as x approaches negative infinity is 2. 4 minus 0 is 4, and the square root of 4 is 2. So this is now equal to 3 over 2 plus 2. Then this is now equal to 3/4. So the answer is 3/4.